Jules Verne made him famous as a monster, and now he's the National Museum of Natural History's newest star attraction.
Yeah, looks like a crab.
What is it? Is it an octopus?
It's a squid.
Yes, it's a giant squid, preserved in 150 gallons of alcohol. When he was alive, this fellow measured 30 feet and weighed 450 pounds, but that's only half grown for a giant squid. Because they're almost never seen by humans, these creatures have been the stuff of legends, but they're not really monsters, says Smithsonian zoologist Clyde Roper.
The myths that have been perpetuated through the years are very much exaggerated. The major difference between giant squids and small squids, the kind that we use for fish bait or the kind that we eat in restaurants or hopefully even in our homes, is size alone.
The Smithsonian giant squid washed ashore on Plum Island, Massachusetts in February 1980. After a year on display, it will join other squids of all sizes in Dr. Roper's laboratory. It's hoped that close-up study of these creatures will solve some of the mysteries of how they live. For instance, scientists have already learned that a squid swims by jet propulsion, drawing water into its body and then squirting it out through a funnel. Its mouth actually resembles a parrot's beak, and each suction cup on its 10 arms is a tool for capturing food.
And it operates very much like a plumber's helper, where the sucker stock, which is a muscular rod, contracts and pulls a vacuum on the suction cup itself, which then adheres to the prey.
Clyde Roper has been studying squids for over 20 years, and he's now writing a book for the United Nations on edible varieties. Here at the Smithsonian, I'm Ann Carroll.